heart attack occurs more frequently in the middle age and older age group in our society, that is in the 50s and above. So usually in the age group of 50, 60, 70, 80 are affected most commonly. But however, people in the younger age group also can be affected because of heart attack, because of the habit of smoking and the stressful environment in which they work. So nowadays we see people with the age of 30, 40 with heart attacks. So women are comparatively protected from heart attack because of the continuous menstruation, which has high estrogen levels, and that's why they are comparatively less affected during the menstrual period, that is till menopause. So, but however, they also get affected like the men after the age of 50. And women, if they are diabetic, they are equally susceptible like men, even in the younger age groups. So we all know that heart attack is a very serious problem which occurs in the society. In the age group of 50s means it spoils the whole family by losing a member of the family who is a breadwinning member of the family. The whole family gets into doldrums. So the prevention of heart attack is very, very important. And secondly, it's a fact that 50% of the people with heart attack die before they reach the hospital. Another 5 to 10% die after reaching the hospital. So prevention of heart attack is more important than treatment. Actually, what is heart attack? Why it occurs? What are the symptoms of heart attack? Actually, if anybody who has got a central type of chest pain, that is pain in the center of the chest with sweating, is deemed to be a heart attack unless proved otherwise. The other commonest cause of sweating is low sugar levels. So then if you exclude a low sugar level, and mostly it is due to heart attack only. How will you diagnose heart attack? The heart attack can be diagnosed by test, but by doctor examining you, by taking an ECG and by other blood tests. So with that, you will be able to know whether you have got a heart attack or not. So why heart attack occurs? Heart attack occurs because of deposition of fat in the coronary arteries. What is coronary artery? Coronary artery is the artery which supplies blood supply to the heart. Why fat deposition occurs? Fat deposition occurs because of high cholesterol. Actually, the cholesterol gets deposited in all the blood vessels from the age of 25 for everybody. In some people it is high, some people it is low. So if it is high, it causes heart attack. It can cause brain stroke also. So there are certain factors which causes increased deposition of fat. For example, if you are a diabetic, you are 4 times more prone to develop heart attack and because of the increased fat deposition. Yeah, if you are hypertensive, you are likely to get more fat deposited in your blood vessels. So same way, if you have lack of exercise and sedentary habits, obesity, genetic factors, all your stressful personality, all these can cause heart attacks. So to prevent a heart attack, you must change the modifiable risk factors. That is what you can do is, for example, if you do exercise regularly, then and if you keep your weight within the normal range, you can prevent or delay the heart attacks. So secondly, if you are a diabetic, if you keep your diabetics under control, the blood sugar under control, you can prevent a heart attack. If you have high cholesterol, you must keep your cholesterol levels below the normal range. That is, for example, the LDL level below 70, you can prevent a heart attack. So all these are very, very important. The blood pressure also is equally important and is one of the commonest risk factor, and the blood pressure should be maintained around 130 by 85. So all these things prevent the fat deposition and will keep you free from heart attack. See, if you take cholesterol, what is cholesterol? What are the different types of cholesterol? Actually, cholesterol is a fatty substance in the body. It is required for certain hormones. For example, hormonal action in the body requires fat. But if the level of the cholesterol is higher than normal, so you develop heart attack. For example, there is a cholesterol known as LDL cholesterol. That cholesterol is bad. So the LDL cholesterol level, if it is more than 100, it causes heart attack. So actually, though, you must reduce the LDL cholesterol level to less than 70. So what are the type? How you can reduce LDL cholesterol? So you can reduce LDL cholesterol by changing your dietary habits, by reducing your fat in the diet, but secondly by doing regular exercise, and by taking certain good medicines called statins. These medicines, if you are taking a high dose, they reduce the cholesterol level remarkably, because your restriction of food and doing exercise can reduce cholesterol only to certain extent. They cannot reduce remarkably. So the statins reduce the cholesterol level remarkably. There is one cholesterol known as HDL cholesterol, that is good cholesterol. That cholesterol level, if it is high, it removes the fat from the arteries. So that level should be high. That can be increased by exercise and statins. So there is another bad cholesterol called as LPA, that is lipoprotein little a. That also can be reduced by exercise. And there is one more cholesterol called as triglycerides, which is more common in diabetics. These triglycerides are not directly harmful, but they change the morphology of the LDL cholesterol so that the fat gets deposited in the coronary arteries. So by doing exercise regularly, by eating a healthy diet, and by taking medicines to reduce cholesterol regularly, you can keep your cholesterol under control and you can prevent a heart attack. Okay, then what are the sometimes some people develop heart attack even without the chest pain. For example, there can be symptoms like vomiting, there can be symptoms like nausea, there can be breathlessness, there can be even fits, can be a heart attack. For example, in elderly age group, that is above the age of 70, and people with diabetes, heart attacks can occur even without chest pain. So these people, that is elderly people and diabetes, if they have any small symptoms also, they must go to the doctor and check whether it is due to heart attack or anything else. So, but when after you develop a heart attack, how you are going to treat the patient? See, what are all the facilities available for treatment of heart attack? See, for example, if you develop a chest pain and it is diagnosed, you must immediately go to the doctor. And if he develops a heart attack, if you go within 3 hours of chest pain, then you can undergo a specialized treatment called primary angioplasty. That is, what they do is, you put a wire into the coronary artery, they remove the block and put a stent inside the coronary arteries. This is the best treatment for heart attack. Second best treatment is thrombolytic therapy. That actually, heart attack is due to the deposition of blood clots over the fatty deposits. This thrombolytic therapy can reduce the blood clot and open up the blood vessel to certain extent, and then so that your damage to the heart is reduced. But this should be followed by a regular coronary angiogram to find out whether you have got a fixed block or not. And if the fixed block is there, then you must undergo angioplasty or bypass surgery. You can undergo angioplasty or bypass surgery as per the results of the coronary angiogram. So this is the final treatment for heart attacks. But however, before you develop a heart attack, you must be able to screen patients. That is, you must be able to go to the doctor and ask whether he is liable to get heart attack. For example, those at high risk of developing heart attacks, like those who have a genetic background, that is hereditary family history of heart disease, or those who are diabetics, those who are hypertensive, those who have got a stressful environment in which they work, they can undergo certain tests called echocardiogram and treadmill test, and they can diagnose whether they are going to get heart attack early so that they can prevent a heart attack and get treated for the same. Thank you.